Hello everyone, I am Gauri Bhote, Assistant Professor in VPKBIT Baramati. I welcome you all to my video lecture. So this is video of subject Engineering Mathematics 3 and this is video from unit Linear Differential Equation and topic of today's lecture is Shortcut Method for Finding Particular Integration. So in this video we see how to find out PI and what is PI. So just I revise general solution for linear differential equation. So we know that for any linear differential equation, phi of d into y is equal to f of x, its general solution contains two parts. So one is complementary function, we denote it as CF, and second is particular integration, this is PI. So, general solution is normally given as CF plus PI, or we can write Y is equal to YC plus YP, where YC is complementary function, YP means particular integral. Now, in my last lecture, we see method for finding complementary function. So, various cases depending upon the roots we discussed. So, if you want to see, so you just go through this link. So in that video, I discuss about method for finding complementary functions. Okay. Now we see first what is particular integral. So particular integration of linear differential equation phi of d into y is equal to f of x is function of x y p such that phi of d y p is equal to f of x. That means it is one function of x such that when I operate phi of d operator on that function, I get resultant RHS function. So function which satisfy given differential equation is known as particular integration PI. So if I rearrange this, I shift this phi of d operator on RHS, it become 1 upon phi of d, and now we can treat this as a standard formula for finding PI. So PI is equal to, or YP is equal to 1 upon phi of d into f of x, where f of x is RHS function and phi of d is the operator in d on this function y. Okay. Now note that for particular integral does not contain any arbitrary constant. Arbitrary constants are contained in complementary function, but in PI there is no arbitrary constant. So even if it include integration, we are not considering any constant term. Second, if our differential equation is homogeneous, homogeneous means my f of x is 0, then my PI is equal to 0. So if f of x is 0, then we operate this 1 upon phi of d on 0, we are getting resultant is 0. So particular integration is also 0, and in that case general solution is same as complementary function. Second, we can operate this 1 upon phi of d as a inverse derivative operator, and we can separate it over addition, we can take scalar terms outside of this operator. So 1 upon phi of d, a times f of x plus b times g of x is same as a times 1 upon phi of d f of x plus b times 1 upon phi of d g of x. It means we separate it over addition, we can take scalar constants outside. Now let us see example. Suppose I having function 1 by 6 e raised to x, and I will show that this is particular integration of differential equation d square plus 3d plus 2y is equal to e raised to x. So I operate this operator phi of d, I operate the operator, this operator phi of d on the function yp. So phi of d yp we calculate. So what is my phi of d yp? d square plus 3d plus 2 into 1 upon 6 e raised to x. So I take 1 by 6 outside, then d square of e raised to x, I multiply this inside, plus 3d times e raised to x plus 2 times e raised to x. Now this d means d by dx and the derivative it means. So derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. Second derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x. So it become e raised to x plus 3 as it is e raised to x plus 2 times e raised to x. So it become 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 6 e raised to x into 1 by 6. So 6 get cancelled, we get resultant is e raised to x. So therefore we are getting RHS function. This is my f of x. So RHS f of x. So this is my function yp such that when I operate this phi of the operator on this function, I get resultant f of x function. So therefore this 1 by 6 e raised to x is particular integral. So in this way we calculate or we are getting here. But now here I take randomly and I, by observing the coefficient, and I try this. But each times we cannot judge such PI. So therefore we see methods for finding particular integration. So there are actually three methods. So first method for finding PI is shortcut methods. So this shortcut method is used for particular type of functions. When RHS function is exponential, sine or cosine x, or polynomial in x, or combination of all these functions, then we are using shortcut methods. So there are total 5 shortcut methods. Then second is general method. So if shortcut method is not applicable, then we are using general method. And third is method of variation of parameters. So we are using this method of variation of parameter if it is mentioned in question. Find the particular integration or solve the equation by using variation of parameters, then we are using method third. Okay. Now here we see shortcut methods and we discuss first this. Okay. So if my linear differential equation is standard form or general form is phi of d into y is equal to f of x. And if my RHS function f of x is of the type e raised to ax or a raised to x or sometimes constant k, then we are using this shortcut method 1. And what is the formula for finding? So this 1 upon phi of d e raised to ax is equal to 1 upon phi of a e raised to ax. 1 upon phi of d e raised to ax. It's same as 1 upon phi of the phi of a e raised to a. That means I replace d by a. Okay. So if now we having term, constant term k. I can write that k term, RHS function is constant term. I can write that k is equal to k into 1. And 1 we can write e raised to 0 x. Okay. So, any constant term we can express as k times e raised to 0 x, and when I operate 1 upon phi of d on this term k, I take scalar constant k outside and 1 I write e raised to 0 x, and by using the above formula I replace d by a, but here my a is 0, so I replace d by 0. So, it is 1 upon phi of 0 into 1. Okay. Now second, if my f of x is a raised to x, then also I can express a raised to x as e raised to x. So how we can write? It is a raised to x is e raised to log a raised to x, and I can write it as it is log a times x multiplication. No? And now my new a become log of a. So when 1 upon phi of d a raised to x is 1 upon phi of d e raised to x into here multiplication log a, it is in the power and the coefficient of x is log a, so I replace d by log of a. So 1 upon phi of a and e raised to x log become a raised to x again. So here when RHS function is a raised to x, replace d by log a. If RHS function is constant k, take k outside and replace d by 0. And if RHS function is e raised to ax, replace d by a. Provided in all cases, denominator is non-zero, phi of a must be non-zero. Okay. So, I hope you understand when we are using this shortcut method 1. So, if we having RHS function is either e raised to ax, RHS function is e raised to ax or constant term k or a raised to x, then we are using the method 1. So if it is e raised to ax, then the formula 1 upon phi of d e raised to power ax is equal to 1 upon phi of a e raised to x. We keep e raised to x as it is, replace d by a, provided this is non-zero. Second case, 1 upon phi of d into k is equal to k times 1 upon phi of 0. Okay. And third case, 1 upon phi of d a raised to x is equal to 1 upon phi of log of a into a raised to x. Okay. So this is my shortcut method 1. Now, the condition is required here in each term, phi of a must be non-zero. But what happens if phi of a is 0? That means case of failure. So we discuss here. If my phi of a is 0, then my particular integration is 1 upon phi of d e raised to ax become x upon phi dash of a into e raised to ax. Again provided denominator non-zero. What I do? First I am finding derivative of phi of a and then I replace d by a. So 1 upon phi of d e raised to ax. So if my denominator, when I replace it by phi of a e raised to ax. If my denominator is 0, what I do? I write numerator as x. I am finding derivative of this phi of d, that is phi dash of d. And then again I replace d by a. So here phi dash of a and then into e raised to ax. Again if we are getting 0, we repeat the case. Then I write one more x. So what we having in that case? X square upon phi double dash of a into e raised to ax. So if first derivative is also 0, so we get 2 times 0, numerator is x raised to 2 and denominator is phi double dash of a. Okay. So in this way we are dealing with case of failure. And if we are getting continuously 0 up to nth derivative, where pi is x raised to n plus 1 phi of n minus 1, phi raised to n minus 1, derivative n minus 1, and then again we replace d by a into e raised to ax. Okay. Now we have in shortcut methods, if factor is 1 upon phi of d is 1 upon d minus a and power is e raised to x. And if these two a values are same, then 1 upon d minus a e raised to x is directly x into e raised to x. Okay, because when I replace d by 0, d by a, we are getting 0. So I write numerator is x and denominator is derivative. Derivative of d is 1 into e raised to x. So we get here x e raised to x. So, instead of finding derivative and all this thing, we can use this as a standard result here. So, when this factor is 1 upon d minus a and e raised to ax. This factor a and this a match. Directly I can write x into e raised to ax. Okay. Then suppose we are having 1 upon d minus a square e raised to ax. Two factors are there. Power of d minus a is 2. Then here we write x square upon 2 factorial into e raised to x. And if 1 upon d minus a raised to r power, then we write x raised to r upon r factorial into e raised to x. So we can use this as a standard result. So for example, directly 1 upon d minus 2 e raised to 2x is directly x times e raised to 2x. Or 1 upon d minus 1 square. So square means x square upon 2 factorial into e raised to x. Or 1 upon d minus 2 cube into e raised to 2x, suppose. So this is equal to cube is there. So x cube upon 3 factorial into e raised to 2x. What is final answer? X cube upon 3 factorial e raised to 2x or x cube upon 6 e raised to 2x. So in this way we are using this case of failure. So first we replace d by a. If we are getting 0 in the denominator, we are finding its derivative of phi of d, that is phi dash of d. Then replace d by a and simultaneously write numerator as x. Suppose again when I replace d by a, I am getting 0. So my numerator, I add one more term of x. So x into x become x square. I find out next derivative. So here phi double dash of d. And then I replace d by d. So in this way, we are finding, we replace d. If we get non-zero value, okay. If we get zero value, differentiate. And then replace d by a, take one term of x. If we get non-zero value, okay. If we get 0, write one more power of x, differentiate and replace d by d. Okay. So, we discuss examples. Find particular solution of d square plus 4d plus 3 into y is equal to e raised to 2x. So, what is given in this differential equation? Coefficient of y is phi of d. So, it is d square plus 4d plus 3. RHS function is f of x. It is e raised to 2x. So here, RHS function is of the type e raised to ax. So we apply first rule for finding shortcut length. So what is PI formula? PI is equal to general formula 1 upon phi of d f of x. So it is 1 upon phi of d is d square plus 4d plus 3. F of x is e raised to 2x. Now by shortcut method 1, here I replace the term d by a. Replace d by a. So here d is, a is 2. So in replace d by 2, what I am getting? 1 upon d square means 2 square for 4 times d, so 2 times d plus 3. So I simplify this, 4 plus 8, 12 plus 3, that is 15. So PI is equal to 1 by 15 e raised to 2x. So in this way, just I replace d by a and it is non-zero. Now similarly, second example, if my phi of d is d square minus 5d plus 6 into y, and my f of x is 3 times e raised to 5x. So we have to find out PI for this. So what is my formula for PI? 1 upon phi of d into f of x. So I substitute phi of d is d square minus 5d plus 6. F of x is 3 times e raised to 5x. So this 3 is constant. I take outside and I observe f of x is of the type e raised to ax. I compare here value of a is 5. So I replace d by 5. So here we get 5 square 25 minus 5 into 5 25 plus 6. So this plus 25 minus 25 will get cancelled. What is remaining?
6. So 3 by 6 e raised to 5x means 1 by 2 e raised to 5x. Now another example, find particular solution of d square plus 4d plus 3y is equal to e raised to 3x. Again, RHS is e raised to minus 3x. So, we are using first shortcut method for finding pi. Formula for finding pi is 1 upon pi of d f of x, that is 1 upon d square plus 4d plus 3 into f of x is e raised to minus 3x. Now, I compare with this e raised to ax. What is my value of a? Minus 3. So, I replace d by minus 3. So, check what we are getting. Minus 3 square, that means 9. 4 into minus 3, that is minus 12 plus 3. Okay, plus 3. So, this 9 plus 3 plus 12 minus 12. So, we are getting 0 in the denominator. So, when I replace 0 in the denominator, it means case of failure, okay, 0 in the denominator. So, what we do, we are finding phi dash of d. So, phi of d is d square plus 4d plus 3. So, phi dash of d is 2d plus 4, okay. And then again, I use formula 1 upon phi of d f of x is same as x upon phi dash of a e raised to x when it is 0 initially. So, phi dash of d is 2d plus 4 and I replace d by minus 3. So, it become minus 6 plus 4 minus 2 and I add x term in the numerator when it is case of failure 0. 1 times we are getting 0. So, 1 power of x. Okay. So, when it is case of failure, don't forget to write x. And in denominator, we differentiate phi of d one time and then check replace d by a. If we get non-zero term, then that is our final pi. Okay. Now next, find particular integration of d cube minus 1 into y is equal to e raised to 2x plus 3 raised to x plus 2. Okay. So what is my phi of d? D cube minus 1 and my RHS function is f of x is e raised to 2x plus 3 raised to x plus 2. So my pi is 1 upon phi of d f of x. So it is 1 upon d cube minus 1 into the given RHS function. Now we know that I can separate this operator 1 upon phi of d over addition. So I separate it. So 1 upon d cube minus 1 into e raised to 2x plus 1 upon d cube minus 1 into 3 raised to x plus 1 upon d cube minus 1 into 2. Now for each term there is separate function or separate type of function. So first function is e raised to ax of the type. So in that case we replace d by a. So in first term my f of x is e raised to ax. Okay. In second term is 3 raised to x. That means it is the type a raised to x. And in that case, I replace d by log a. So it is, I replace d by log of d. And in third case, 2 is constant. So I take outside and 2 into 1. 1 I can write e raised to 0x. Okay. So here in first term it is e raised to ax of the type. So I replace d by a, that is d by 2. So 2 cube minus 1. In second case it is a raised to x. So for a raised to x we replace d by log 3. So I write log 3 bracket cube minus 1. And in third case constant term I take outside. And I write 1 is e raised to 0x. So, a become 0. So, I replace d by 0. So, in third case, I replace d by 0. So here we are getting, so 2 cube means 8, 8 minus 1, 7. So it is e raised to 2x by 7. We keep this log 3 bracket cube as it is. We are not finding value. So 3 raised to x upon log 3 bracket cube minus 1. And when I replace d by 0, 0 minus 1 is minus 1. E raised to 0x is 1. So minus 2. So here we get pi e raised to 2x by 7 plus 3 raised to x by log 3 cube minus 1 minus 2 by 1. That is 2. Okay. So we get the solution. So what we do here? RHS is not single function. It is addition of three type of function. So I separate the 1 upon phi of d over addition and I operate or use the formulas according to the function is e raised to x or a raised to x or constant. Now we see one more example. D square minus 2d plus 1 y is equal to e raised to x. So simple phi of d is equal to d square minus 2d plus 1 and my RHS function f of x is e raised to x. So my formula for pi is 1 upon phi of d f of x. So which is equal to 1 upon d square minus 2d plus 1 into e raised to x. Okay. So here my value of a is 1. So, e raised to x, if I compare, so my value of a is 1 and I replace d by 1. So, it is 1 square minus 2 plus 1. But it become 1 plus 1, 2 minus 2, it is 0. So, we are getting case of failure. So, what we do in case of failure? We are finding phi dash of d. And my phi dash of d is derivative of d square is 2d, minus 2d is 2 and plus 1 derivative 0. So my phi dash of d is d square minus 2d. So therefore 1 upon phi of d f of x is same as x upon phi dash of d into e raised to x and now again I replace d by a. So I replace d by a. A is 1. So 2 minus 2, again I am getting 0. Again case fail. So what we do? We are finding second order derivative. So I differentiate it 1 times, phi dash of d, I get phi double dash of d. So derivative of 2d minus 2 is only 2. And what is the formula for finding? Next case, if 2 times 0, then it is x square upon phi double dash of d into e raised to x. So I replace again d by 1. So here it actually constant term to x square into e raised to x. So my pi is x square e raised to x by 2. Okay. So when it is 0 2 times, we are adding the power of x in numerator and differentiate the denominator that many times. Next example. Find particular solution of d minus 1 bracket cube y is equal to e raised to x plus 2 raised to x minus 3 by 2. Okay. So here again RHS is addition of three functions and one is of the type e raised to x, second is a raised to x, third is constant. So for finding pi, first formula is 1 upon phi of d f of x. So therefore 1 upon d minus 1 bracket cube f of x is e raised to x plus 2 raised to x minus 3 by 2. So this operator I separate over addition. So 1 upon d minus 1 cube into e raised to x. It is of the type e raised to x, a is 1 plus second term 1 upon d minus 1 bracket cube into 2 raised to x. So it is of the type a raised to x and a is 2 and third minus 3 by 2. Okay. So third minus 3 by 2 I take outside and I write here it is into 1 is e raised to 0x. So in third case a is 1, a is 0. So I replace d by 0 in third case In first case, e raised to ax. So, I replace d by 1. And in second case, it is a raised to x. So, I replace d by log a, that is log of 2. So, here what we are getting? 1 minus 1, 0. Okay. Second case, replace d by log 2. Third case, the constant term 3 by 2 outside and replace d by 0. But in first case, if you observe, here it is d minus a raised to r into e raised to x. It is of the type 1 upon d minus a raised to power r into e raised to ax. Ax term. Okay. What is formula for this? X raised to r upon r factorial into e raised to ax. So, here my value of r is 3. So, here I write x raised to 3 upon 3 factorial into e raised to 1x. Okay. Then second term I replace d by log 2. So, 1 upon log 2 minus 1 bracket cube into 2 raised to x minus 3 by 2 and replace d by 0. So, 0 minus 1 minus 1 cube, it is minus 1. And this minus minus become plus. Don't simplify this. Don't find out the value of log 2. Keep this term as it is. 1 upon log 2 minus 1 bracket cube into 2 raised to x. And first term x cube upon 3 factorial means x cube upon 6 e raised to x. Okay. So in this way we are finding particular integration for function is e raised to x or a raised to x or constant term. So, you can see one more example. Here, just I expand 1 plus e raised to x bracket square is a plus b square, a square that is 1 plus 2ab, 2 e raised to x plus b square, 3 raised to x is e raised to x, 2x and this 3 plus 1 is 4. So, again my RHS become 2 e raised to x plus e raised to 2x plus 4 and you just solve by previous method. So, in this way, first case is e raised to 1x, replace d by 1. Second case, e raised to 2x, try replace d by 2. Third case, constant, take outside and replace d by 0. So, once if you get case of failure, use x by phi dash of d formula and then again replace d by a. So, you are getting general solution. Okay. So, I hope you understand this. So, we are using the shortcut method. If f of x is e raised to ax, in that case, I replace d by a and then 1 upon phi of d e raised to ax is same as 1 upon phi of a e raised to a, provided denominator non-zero. If it is 0, then x upon phi dash of a e raised to ax and we continue this formula. Second case, if RHS is a raised to x, then I replace d by log a and we keep as it is answer. Third case, if RHS is constant term k, I take k outside of the operator and I write 1 as e raised to 0x, so replace d by 0. So, I hope you understand this. So, thank you for watching this video. To watch more videos on this topic, subscribe my channel. So thank you. Happy learning.